Last month, my Amazon business sold $424,000. And the best part is it only took me about an hour a day to accomplish that. So in this video, I'm gonna be showing you exactly how you can start and scale an Amazon FBA business to a full-time income. And I wanna go ahead and start this out by showing you the exact types of products that you can sell on Amazon. We're also gonna break down the tools you need and how to source new products moving forward into the future for you as an Amazon seller. So I've got this pulled up as an example of a product, right? So these are on clearance at Dick's Sporting Goods. And then over on Amazon, when we click the SellerAmp Chrome extension, this is one of the first tools that we'll need. We'll talk about that here in just a second. When we click the Chrome extension, we can see that the exact same pair of shoes is selling for $116 over on Amazon, and specifically the 8.5s right here that we're looking at on the website. Over on Amazon, that exact same pair of shoes is selling for $108. And when we plug that into our profit calculator, we can see that's going to make us over $22 every time this item sells. And this is just one quick example of a winning product that you can sell on Amazon. And in fact, all of the sales that I made during December are name brand items like shoes, like makeup, and other name brand products. I didn't make any new products. I didn't market. I didn't buy any ads. It's all based on Amazon's marketplace, simply buying items cheap enough to make a profit. And so I'm going to show you exactly how to find more winning products just like this one. But first, I want to show you the tools for the job, right? So you want to keep things very lean. You don't want to get too expensive with it, but you do need our product research tool. This is SellerAmp. And then you're also going to need Keepa. This is another one of the basics. Basically shows you the past history of all the items on Amazon. SellerAmp lets you source products. It shows you the profit, all that good stuff that we'll be diving in here to today. And so those two tools are the only paid tools you need. All in, it's $40 a month. Very cheap to start this business. You really need about $1,000 to start. I had $1,500 when I started my Amazon business, and now we're doing well over $2 million a year. So the other free tools that you'll want, and this is where we're looking at name brand products at everyday websites, right? The free tools that you want to leverage are going to be able to boost your profit margins. The first of them being Capital One Shopping, right? So if we check out Dick's Sporting Goods over here and we click the Capital One Shopping Chrome extension, it's going to find any potential coupon codes, especially when you're looking at other websites. It might say, hey, we found 20 coupon codes or 10 coupon codes, and all of those could be potentially good to look into. So Capital One Shopping, free tool. The next one is Raise, and this allows you to buy discounted gift cards. So let's say you want to buy a discounted gift card at Dick's Sporting Goods that we're just looking at. You can buy $500 gift card for $470 right there. So not only are we making 22% profit, but we can also pay basically 5% less for this product just by buying a discounted gift card, right? So if Capital One Shopping didn't find a coupon code, we can still get at least that 5% off or so as an additional discount. The other thing you want to leverage is cashback services like Top Cashback or Rakuten. These are both free. And when you go into these websites here, you'll be able to see exactly what the highest cashback rates are, right? All in the spirit of boosting your margins on these products. Just want to show you what's possible with this business. And a free tool I'll put you on as well is called Cashback Monitor. So let's say you're looking to buy some products from Dick's Sporting Goods. Seems like Top Cashback would be our highest cashback rate today at 2%. Let's say you want to buy from something like Macy's. You could compare all over the place. So Retail Me Not might be one of those other super high cashback providers. And it's a good idea to just to switch between a couple. Whenever you're placing an order, you might as well check these free resources here, Raise and Cashback Monitor, just to boost your margin a little bit. So in this case, we can get an extra 5% by buying a discounted gift card, and we can get 2% back on Dick's Sporting Goods according to Cashback Monitor, right? So those are two other quick ways to boost your margins on top of this, because I want you to keep in mind that as we start looking for products here, this is the exact sourcing strategy that I use in my business that we did over $400,000 in 1 month. It's really important to keep in mind that all the best items you find, they're rarely going to be profitable at the retail price. So this is a rare exception, just like a good example to show you guys. But a lot of the best products out there, you're going to be stacking a coupon code that you found on Capital One Shopping with some discounted cards and some cash back. And all those little ways are going to be able to boost your margins in ways that other sellers aren't smart enough to figure out. And so that keeps your items good for the long run. A very common complaint that I hear with people who start Amazon arbitrage, or just buying from, you know, name brand items, flipping it, is they buy it and the price drops. 99 times out of 100, that's just because they weren't looking in the right places. They weren't leveraging the right discounts, and their competition beat them on price. So make sure you're leveraging those three, especially as we start digging in and start finding this first profitable product. So replicate this exact method I'm about to show you, and you will be well on your way to finding your first $5,000-$10,000 worth of products, right? So when we're within SellerAmp here, we now have identified this as a profitable product, right? So there's other third-party sellers who are selling this shoe profitably, and it's reasonable to assume that other items they're selling are also going to be profitable. So I want to check out some of the other stores on the offers tab, especially looking at low feedback sellers. So these guys have 500 feedback. This guy has 1,700 feedback. right? So they're probably very good at product sourcing and they might be better than you. They've been doing this for years. They've made probably millions of dollars in sales if they have that many feedback. And so you want to be targeting the people with less feedback, like this one right here. So they've got 27 feedback, another 900. I might check out this one here with 46 feedback. And the reason we're looking at these actual storefronts is, like I said, they're going to have way lower chances of finding stuff at crazy wholesale prices or looping some crazy discount strategies that we're just not going to be able to identify as a beginner. So open up a profitable listing. You can start from this exact listing that I showed you today, and then start clicking through the low feedback sellers to find some more products for yourself. This is called reverse sourcing. It's the best way to start your Amazon business. This is how I started my Amazon business. This is how we do a ton of our product research to this day. And this is how my team that does most of my product research. Again, I mentioned that I only work about an hour a day on this business. I'll talk about what my team does, how they're sourcing, how I built that team here in just a second as well. But I want to show you how to find what I want to get back to the basics, right? So let's figure out how to find a profitable product from here. So as we're looking through the storefront view, we can see a lot of good information, right? In this example, we can see a lot of the sellers are around like that $100 price point. We can see the embedded price chart over here. So this is basically charting the supply and price over time, that green being sales rank, closer to one it is, the faster it's selling. And then the orange price is going to be the price over time. So hopping all over the place, relatively consistent, but really you just want to be looking for some consistency in that pricing. The next thing that's really important to look at is the max cost option. This is basically something we do at SellerAmp to tell you exactly what you need to find your items for it to meet your profit threshold. So in this case, if I want to make $3 profit or 35% ROI, I would need to be able to find this item for $73.05 or less. And as a brand new seller, you're going to have no idea if you can find these items for that price. As a more veteran seller, the more you start looking through these storefronts, the more you're going to be able to skip over items and understand when you might be able to find something for that price and when you might not. So this seller seems like they're just going crazy all in on some Nike products. So if that's something you're personally passionate about, shoes, Nikes, that kind of stuff, if you like makeup, start looking through people who are selling makeup. Use any kind of personal interest you have in these products and start from there. So for me, I like to source a lot of clothes, shoes, that kind of thing. That's just what I've gotten good at over the last several years. But really, there's opportunity everywhere. Like I said, if we think we can buy this item for $3, we're going to go ahead and hit the Google button right here, or we can also open the Amazon listing. And when you press the Google button, it's just going to copy this text and paste it. So in this case, it's just going to say women's sneaker. So if it ever is like that, I'll go into the actual Amazon listing and then we can hit Google. If we're looking at an item like this Elite Pro right here, if we hit Google, it'll probably pull up the right item right away. Just a quick thing to help you make a little bit more money there. So let's go ahead and start checking through here, right? So we've got these Court Legacy Lift shoes. We need to find them for, what was it, about $73 to be profitable on these. And so let's start digging in through here and see if we can find any of these for that price. So Rakuten's giving us a couple extra percent here. We can also get 10% off our order. This is a nugget for you guys. You're going to want to set up what's called a catch-all email, and that's just going to allow you to create basically an infinite number of coupon codes. If you don't have that set up, you will need like a custom website. So my name is Warner, obviously. Let's say my email address is warner@gmail.com. If you want to make an infinite amount of coupon codes, you can just add a plus one, right? And then it'll redirect to whatever's before the plus. So I know it's a little bit higher level. I want you to be in on that so that you can always leverage these infinite 10% discount codes. So next time I want to make a 10% code, I'll just do plus two, or you could just spam it every time and you'll get a 10% code kind of sent to your email every time, right? So be sure you leverage that. In this case, that 10% off on $90 is not going to get us down to that $70 that we were looking for. So we can click out of that. This one, however, does seem like we could be looking at something somewhat interesting, right? So seems like this probably is the same item. They're $70. They're on a pretty good sale right now over at Academy. And this particular shoe we're looking at right now is at $109. So we're making $15 in profit. It's not the highest ROI, and especially with shoes, I like to be a little bit pickier. You got to deal with returns and all that kind of stuff. But this is a great starting point. So let's go ahead and check out the variations down here. And this is where Keepa starts to come into play. This is our other product research tool. And let's go ahead and filter this by highest price. And the reason we're going to do this is $109 is maybe a little bit cheap for what we want to sell on this listing, but I want to see if there's any more expensive versions of this shoe that we can go ahead and hop on. So let's see. So this one right here, size 11s are up at 130. So we could check those out. And especially let's see what it maybe has sold for in the past as well. So right now it's at $115. So we're getting very close, 28% ROI, $20 profit. As a new seller, don't be too picky, right? I like to look for $3 or 3% ROI as my kind of profit threshold, but I've seen so many Amazon sellers' businesses die being perfectionists, right? So something like this, you'd probably just want to go ahead and pull the trigger as a new Amazon seller, make some profit, especially as a $20 profit per unit. We got a pretty big cushion for the price to potentially go down or anything like that. We can also see on Keepa that this did recently sell up here for 140. So there's even a chance that the price could go back up and let's see, like 167, you'd be really making some money there. So you're making $60 to $3 for a $70 item if that price did happen to shoot back up. And so that's the bare basics of product research. I have a ton of other videos on my channel where I'm literally just sourcing products. If I went a little bit fast for you here, go check out some of the other videos on my channel. There's 15, 20, 30 minute tutorials of me literally just sitting there there, sourcing products, finding some good stuff together. Because especially if this is your first video about Amazon, I'm sure it's a little bit like drinking from the fire hose. And that's okay, right? Amazon is not supposed to be easy. It's not supposed to be easy to change your financial future. If it was, we wouldn't all be stuck at the office for 40 years, right? I didn't want that for my life. I don't want that for your life. I want you to be able to buy that time freedom and have a little bit more freedom in your life. And that's on the other side of spending a couple months learning a skill, giving it genuine effort, and not giving up after you source for a couple hours like most Amazon sellers do. So with that in mind, to keep finding more profitable products, all you have to do is keep scrolling through the storefront right here. Anytime you think you can buy the item for the max cost, you're going to hit the Google button, bang, open it up, look a little bit further, right? So I want to also talk about some a little bit higher level things that helped me really scale my business to over $400,000 a month, all just off these products like this, right? So I've been doing this business since 2018 now. And the beautiful part of selling on Amazon for that long is you start to develop a huge catalog of products that you can repeatedly come back to and sell. These are called replenishables. And that's really where this business model scales, right? But if you're watching this video as a brand new seller, you don't have that catalog. So I want to show you a hack that I used to really expand on the number of items that I knew I wanted to source for the Christmas season. In this case, I did over 400K in the month of December. Really easy month to have an awesome sales month with gifting season, all that kind of stuff. By no means is it a typical month for me. But something that really helped me was looking for items that go crazy every certain season, right? So I pull up this pair of pants as an example, because I noticed that down here on the Keepa chart, this green sales rank line is showing us how fast it sells in comparison to other clothing products. And as we got closer to December of 2022, we can see that sales rank line kept shooting closer and closer to one, being closer to the best-selling clothing item in all of Amazon. And at the same time, the price of this item went from $55 right there all the way up to $71. So I wanted to be able to store this information. And so I put it on a Google Sheet. And so I stored this information on a Google Sheet using SellerAmp. So for example, we can just scroll down here. We can click Christmas, and then it's going to go ahead and export that item over here to our custom configurable Google Sheet. You can set up whatever you want on here. This is also how I like to basically track any of the good leads that I've found, all the products that are coming in. I like to separate out my virtual assistant team based on who's finding what. They just click their name. There's a lot of applications for this, but it's going to be really useful for you as a new seller to start building a catalog of products that are going to be really good during a certain season. So you're going to stumble across these naturally. There's no reason to forget about them. I didn't want to forget about the good products that I found for the Christmas season. And so I started making lists like this, right? So now we had that big Christmas list, and then bang, this Christmas season, we can see that the price was $50 going into the Christmas season. And right now, even after the Christmas season, it's first couple of days of January right now, it's still at an $87 item when it was usually a $50 item. So all it comes down to is stocking up on items that go crazy during a certain season, leveraging seasonality. And the beautiful part of Amazon is we have all the data right in front of us. We don't really have to take any risks hoping that our products will sell. We know that the products will sell. We can see it in the data right here. We can know that people want to buy very popular Nike sweatpants like this one right here. All we have to do is start cataloging that super well and just trying to remember that, right? The other thing that's a little bit higher level that I want you to start doing as you're looking through these websites. So today we are looking at Dick's Sporting Goods and Academy and that kind of thing. There's also going to be tons of items on, let's say, Nike.com, just for the sake of continuity here. Whenever you're checking around these websites, start writing down the coupons that you're seeing, right? So on Nike.com today, doesn't really seem like they have a coupon. We can see if Adidas might, up to 60%. Off sale items, not a lot going on, right? So there's 4% from Rakuten. But what you really want to start doing is recording the best coupons that you've seen on that website. So for me, some of the best coupons I've seen are like 30% at Nike, 30% at Adidas, 25% at Walgreens. And then whenever those coupon codes roll back around, I know that's a good time to start comparing items that other Amazon sellers are selling to that individual website. So instead of just guessing what website I might be sourcing against, I'm going to look at a seller's storefront. I'm going to know in the back of my mind, hey, Nike's having a really good sale today. It's 25% off. I'm going to start looking at the storefronts of people who are already selling good Nike products. So you don't have to know anything about the category. You just have to know to click and open other seller storefronts who are already good at selling the products that you ideally want to be selling later on. So this just helps you stay on track of what's good, what's actually a sale, when the brand is saying, hey, it's our best sale of the year. And you got your spreadsheet up. No, it's not. I saw you had a 50% off sale a week ago. What are you talking about? So that's where you want to really be able to prioritize. Then that also comes into play when you're trying to have lower costs than anyone else in the game is buying on the best coupons around. That's going to help you do that. And so just a really good tip, I wish I had done this from the start. It'll help you make a ton more money than I did in my first year, is if you're leveraging everything I'm showing you here, you're going to have a much faster jump start. It took me about a year to do my first $100,000 in sales. I see a lot of new guys coming in doing it in 6 months. Some people are even doing it in 2 or 3 months these days because of the free information, the wealth of community, and all the good stuff that's out for you to take advantage of. And as promised, I also want to go ahead and break down how I only spend about an hour a day on this business. If you're anything like me, I didn't want to start a hustle, right? Sometimes it can be very toxic. You got to be working 24/7. It's your life. life. Business is everything, right? That's not the type of business that I wanted to be starting. Hopefully it's not the business that you want to be starting. If it is, great, you're going to make a lot of money. I wanted to be able to buy my freedom back, right? I didn't want to be able to escape the 9-to-5 just to buy myself another one, right? So there's two big things that I implemented to be spending way less time on my business. The first of those being virtual assistants. So I've hired a team of virtual assistants from the Philippines. They make anywhere from $3 to $8 an hour, which is a very good wage in the Philippines. It's the equivalent of kind of a decent desk job over here in the United States. They don't have to leave the house. They don't have to worry about getting in a car accident or anything like that. And we can provide really well-paying jobs to people who are very hard workers, right? So my team from the Philippines, they're finding all these items for me. I'm not doing any of the work of finding these products myself anymore because I put in the hard work, spending a couple years learning the process, understanding what's a good item, how to find more good items, and then understanding how to train people like you, like my team, how to find more profitable products. I also have people on my team who are reviewing all the products they find. They're buying all the products for me. And so a lot of times it's pretty funny. They're spending over $100,000 a month of my money. And sometimes I have no idea what it is until it's already making me money. And I'm really proud of my team. They're amazing. And I'm proud of the systems we've been able to build in a legitimate business. And I'm hopeful that you can get to the same point as well. The second thing that I implemented to pull myself out of the business is a prep center, right? So a lot of times when you start a business, you're going to be shipping out orders all day, every day. And that's not something that you need to be doing in the long run. In fact, it might make sense for you to never do it. Because if you pay sales tax in your state, so we're looking at Dick's Sporting Goods today, right? I started my business out of a state with 10% sales tax. So I would have paid $6 to send those shoes to me just in sales tax. Or I can send them off to a sales tax-free prep center in a state like Montana. I'll pay them $1.50 to prep that item for me. And so they're going to receive the item. They're going to unbox it all. They're going to put a sticker on it. They're going to ship it off to Amazon for about 40 cents a pound. Typically what you pay for shipping on these items, by the way, all factored in throughout the video. And so instead of paying $6 and doing work, I do no work and I pay them $1.50, right? So it's a huge win. It's very rare in business. You can spend less money and spend less time doing something, but prep centers have been massive for me to increase the value of my time. And so if you're ready to get started and scale to $10,000 a month and beyond, I threw together an awesome free resource for you. I'll link this down below. It's our free course and community, couple hours of content, some PDFs, some spreadsheets, a list of ASINs that you can get auto ungated in. So you can get approved to sell big name brands just with a big list that we threw together there for you. Check this out. This will be down there in the description. And you're also going to want to take advantage of the free live class that we've got going on. So the next one we're doing is on January 10th. If you're watching after that, click the link down below. We've been doing these every couple weeks, but these have been a lot of fun. You can come ask questions. These are much more structured. Usually it's about a little over an hour of pure value for your business. Plus we do a Q&A, hang out for a little bit. It's a ton of fun. I think you'll learn a lot. And it's just good to get in that live environment, start talking with some other Amazon sellers. So check both of those free resources out down below. But I really appreciate you guys watching this video. Let me know if you have any questions, comments, anything like that. Feel free to drop those down below as well. Please subscribe, like, all that good stuff. Helps me out with the YouTube algorithm if you did get value from today. But I really appreciate you guys watching this video, and I will see you next time.